Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another Music of the Americas video. So for today, I will be covering salsa. I know there were a few of you that really wanted me to cover this genre of music, so I will be doing that in today's video. So I think to properly understand the origin of salsa, you kind of have to look at the progression of both Cuban and Puerto Rican music just before salsa kind of emerged, but with a specific focus in New York, since that was kind of the birthplace of what we know today as salsa. So if you guys would like to get to know a little history of salsa, just keep on watching. Salsa is a dance genre that initially arose in New York City during the 1960s. It is the product of various musical genres, including Cuban song, guaracha, cha-cha-cha, and mambo, as well as Puerto Rican bomba en plena. Some of the instruments typically used in salsa include the piano, bongo drums, congas, timbales, trumpet, maracas, cowbell, various forms of the guitar, saxophone, violin, and many more instruments. Salsa is primarily Cuban song, which itself is a fusion of Spanish song or cantar and Afro-Cuban percussion, merged with North American music styles such as jazz. The first salsa bands were predominantly Cubans and Puerto Ricans that moved to New York beginning in the early 20th century. The music would eventually spread throughout Colombia and the rest of the Americas, ultimately becoming a global phenomenon. Prior to the 1960s, New York had been a center of Cuban-style music since the 1940s, with bands such as Machitos Afro-Cubans ushering in the mambo era. Tito Puente had worked for a time in the Afro-Cubans band before starting up his own band. By the 1950s, the three reigning mambo groups in New York included Machito and his Afro-Cubans, Tito Puente, and Tito Rodriguez. The next Latin craze to hit the US would be the cha-cha-cha, and the final distinct Latin music era to emerge pre-salsa was the boogaloo. By the mid-1960s, a hybrid New Yorican cultural identity had emerged, primarily Puerto Rican but influenced by many other cultures, as well as by the close contact with African Americans. The biggest boogaloo hits of the 60s was Bang Bang by the Joe Cuba Sextet, which sold over 1 million copies. The late 1960s in America saw white youth joining a counterculture heavily associated with political activism, black youth formed organizations like the Black Panthers, and Latinos in New York formed the Young Lords. They rejected assimilation and made the barrio a cauldron of militants' assertiveness and artistic creativity. This social change would also have an impact on the musical scene of the time, and so would be the birth of what we now know as salsa. The Manhattan-based recording company Fania Records introduced the first generation salsa singers and musicians to the world. Founded by Dominican bandleader Johnny Pacheco and Italian-American Jerry Masucci, Fania launched with Puerto Rican artists Willie Colon and Hector Lavoe. Celia Cruz, who had already had a successful career by then, was able to transition well into the salsa scene in the United States and would even become known as the Queen of Salsa.
Thank you.
In 1971, the Fania All-Stars sold out Yankee Stadium, and they would continue introducing Puerto Rican salsa stars to an ever-growing and diverse crowd of Latino audiences. From New York, salsa quickly expanded to Puerto Rico, the Dominican Republic, Colombia, Nicaragua, Venezuela, and other Latin American countries. During the 1980s, Venezuelan artist Oscar de Leon became a huge star, and in Colombia, a new generation of musicians began to combine salsa with elements of cumbia and vallenato. Joe Arroyo and his band La Verdad popularized Colombian salsa during the 80s, and he also worked for many years with Colombian arranger Fruco y sus Tesos. It wasn't until the mid-1980s that salsa actually caught up in Cuba, despite its Cuban origins, as many rejected salsa, considering it a cheap imitation of Cuban music. However, by the late 1980s, a new sound would emerge, salsa cubana, a term which for the first time included Cuban music as part of salsa. Several bands of Cuban salsa emerged by the mid-1990s, including Manolito y su Trabuco and Orquesta Sublime. The term salsa cubana eventually fell out of favor, though, and would be replaced with timba. Now moving on to the other side of the world, salsa has been popular in sub-Saharan Africa since the mid-20th century. To many Africans, the clave-based Cuban music sounded both familiar and exotic. By the 1940s, Afro-Cuban son groups had gained widespread popularity in the Congo region, and many Congolese bands started doing Cuban covers and creating their own Cuban-like compositions, with lyrics sung in French or Lingala. The largest wave of Cuban music to hit Africa was in the form of salsa. In 1974, the Fania All-Stars performed in Zaire, known today as the Democratic Republic of Congo. Fast forward to today, it is still very common for African artists to record salsa tunes and add their own particular regional touch to it. From the 1990s to now, salsa has been able to receive much commercial success, as was seen in the 90s by mixing salsa with contemporary pop styles with Puerto Rican artists like Tito Nieves, Marc Anthony, and La India. Sun by Four, Victor Manuel, and Gloria Estefan enjoyed crossover success within the white American pop market with their Latin-infused hits, usually sung in English. Throughout his lifetime, salsa has always seemed to inspire an instant reaction to Latin music lovers everywhere. The rhythm, the dance, and the musical excitement sends millions of people to the dance floor, Latino or not.
Hacia el espacio, dale la bienvenida a mis manos. Juro no recorrerte en vano. Estoy deseando que en esta ciudad se vaya la luz y le enciendas. Rózame la vida y no tengas miedo de morder las frutas prohibidas. Cierra las salidas, voy a darte un beso que juro no se te olvida. Dale la bienvenida a mis labios. Decirte que al final eso no ha funcionado. Puedes darte cuenta quien perdió más de la cuenta. Fuiste tú, te quedas sin amor si es que sientes su ausencia. Y es que mi corazón para tanta desilusión él no fue diseñado. Si esto fue un juego,
alright, and that concludes this video, guys. I do hope that you all enjoyed it. Let me know your feedback down below. Of course, I know I didn't include every single big salsa artist. There's so many, but I tried to give as good as an overview as I could. So, as always, leave me your feedback. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll check you all in the next one. Bye!